A horrific accident on a Santa Fe highway. A man hit by car after car, his body flying all over Highway 599 near Camino La Tierra. Secretary of State Dianna Duran says she was one of the people who hit him. Target 7's Lauren Zakalik is looking at this story from all angles and joins us now in the studio.
Royal Santa Fe police say at this point, Secretary of State Duran will not face charges for this grisly accident, nor will any of those other drivers. The secretary says she's shocked and saddened by the whole thing, but she's keeping a low profile the day after the accident.
Santa Fe police say body parts of a 46-year-old northern New Mexico man were scattered all over Highway 599 near Camino La Tierra after one car hit him and numerous others followed. This is exclusive video of the accident.
This is a rates pretty high up there as far as graphic scenes.
But Action 7 News was the first to reveal one of those cars was driven by Secretary of State Dianna Duran.
I did speak with the secretary last night, and she was very emotional, very traumatized.
Santa Fe Police Captain Eric Wheeler says the man had been walking down the middle of the highway around 7:30 Thursday night. Duran released a statement Friday saying she'd thought she hit an animal. Learning it was a human, she says she's sure other drivers are just as shocked and saddened to learn what really took place.
Santa Fe police say their preliminary investigations show Secretary Duran was likely the third person to hit the man in the road, though they believe he had already died by the time she hit him.
We tried to reach the secretary.
Hi, this is Dianna.
But never heard back. She was not in her office all day either on Friday.
Again, at this point, none of the drivers involved are facing charges for hitting the man, but that could change depending on factors like speed. But coming up at 6, we'll dig even deeper into what exactly happened at the accident scene and why Duran drove all the way home before calling police. Royal.
Well, police are not yet releasing the victim's name. He did have ID on him, but because of his injuries, they're first doing fingerprint checks and calling family to make sure they have the